Melody, Maya, and Emma, ages 14, 12, and 10, were at their new school. The three of them almost never got along. But their mom said they had to or they would be in big trouble. When they got home from school, they saw that their mom had left a note on the front door that told them to go look around their new house. When they got inside, the first thing they saw was a note on the front door that said, "Hi world, you like to play a game? Open the door." They opened the door and saw the impossible. It's a portal. Yes, it's a portal. Melody and Emma wanted to go through the door, but Maya was doubtful about whether or not they should go inside. "I don't know, guys, what if we can't get back? It's a 2-to-1 we're going, but you don't have to come if you don't want to," Maya said. "Fine. But don't go blaming me if something goes wrong," said Maya. When they got through the door, they found themselves in a room that looked a lot like their living room, but it's bigger. "Guys," apostrophe said Emma, apostrophe "why is the room so big?" Melody looked around and said, "I don't think the room got bigger, I think we shrunk. Hurry up. Just look around for a door. Or something that might be the portal back." But before they got the chance, they found a sign that said, "If you want to go home, you have to find 3 keys." "I told you this was a bad idea. This is all your fault," Maya yelled. "No. This is Melody's fault. She's the oldest. She's supposed to be the responsible one," said Maya, changing her mind. "No," said Melody. "This is all of our faults. We all decided to go, and arguing isn't going to get us back either. Now, are you going to help find the keys or not?" They started looking for the keys. They looked in the bedroom, in the closet, and under the bed. Then they found a key. Emma yelled, "Guys, I found a key in the drawer. I'm too small to reach it." "Here, get on my back," said Melody. Then she reached down into the drawer and grabbed it. "Let's go. Come on." When they got there, they found another sign that said only one person can go through the door at a time. "Emma should go first, she's the youngest," said Melody. So, they helped their little sister through the door, and watched as she disappeared in front of their eyes. "We really need to find those keys," said Melody. "Agreed," said Maya. "Let's look in the bathroom next." They looked in the bathtub, the trash can, and the sink. "Melody, I found it." "Well, let's go then. We're not getting any bigger standing around her." But when they got to the door and tried to use the key, another sign popped up and said, "This is a fake key." "Oh, really?" Maya said in disbelief. They were so upset. They thought that they were never going to be able to go home. They thought that they had looked everywhere. "We're never going to be able to go home," she said, kicking a bookshelf. Then, they both heard a little cling on the floor. "Maya, you did it. You found the last key." They went to the door and the sign popped up again. "Only one person can go through the door at a time. Maya, you use the key and tell Mom I love her." "No. Tell her yourself." "What?" Melody started to say. But she didn't finish her sentence because Maya pushed her through the portal. Maya knew she was stuck. Game over, she thought. But then another sign popped up that said, "Congratulations. You passed the test. You worked together with your siblings to get home." Then the portal door opened and she walked in. Maya, Emma, and Melody said as soon as they saw her. "Let's promise to never fight again," said Emma. "Agreed," said Maya and Melody. They were finally home. The next day, at school, Melody went up to the school bully and told her, "Hey, come over to my house. I want to show you something. And by the way, bring 2 friends." And so when they got to their house after school, she opened the portal door, and the school bully and her friends went in.